Special thanks to these companies for being long-term partners of this channel.
Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. So this is gonna be not too long of a video, but I kinda wanna do a walkthrough. I made the decision of kinda doing this as a point of view rather than filming myself because I figured it might be a little more interesting and I can show you the ins and outs while holding my camera on my gimbal, so it's just a little more enjoyable to watch. Tried to not be too shaky. So if you like what I'm doing with the channel, if you've stuck around even though I haven't posted in the last couple weeks, I appreciate it and consider subscribing because we've got a lot of exciting content coming. A lot of my Land Cruiser projects are just starting or finishing up. I'm kind of in this middle area where I've got some pretty sweet content right on the verge of being posted. So stay tuned, that's coming really soon. But this is the kind of probably most exciting project I think I've had going on. This is like a DIY rooftop tent. And I started this probably back in January and I've been just slowly working on it on and off. I didn't assemble it and have it take up my living room up until maybe a couple months ago. But we're trying to get it finished up here so I can get it moved out. So first of all, the outside of this tent shell is built out of 1.5 inch aluminum extrusions. So the top here has a 1.5 by 1.5 inch aluminum extrusion. The bottom is 4.5 by 1.5. And the reason I went with these dimensions was because I wanted to use a 4 inch XPED mattress. So one of my kind of, pet peeves of some of the older rooftop tents I've used is they had like 1.5 inch thick mattresses or even thinner. I just didn't find them very comfortable. You know, I think a lot of people might say that you should be able to sleep with just about anything if you're gonna go camping, but honestly, I like to be comfortable when I'm out camping, so I opted for something a little bit thicker. So that's kind of why I went with this. So another comment I'm probably gonna get pretty early on is, did you basically copy Ripcord's plans? So Ripcord, if you don't know who he is, he has a YouTube channel. He makes some awesome content, and he did entire DIY go fast camper-esque build for his Tacoma, and the build that he did is essentially all documented. He's got some YouTube videos on it, he's got a bunch of forum walkthroughs, and yeah, I did draw some inspiration from his build. This isn't designed exactly like his, but it has some similarities. It's hard to not copy someone in some fashion if you're building a rooftop tent out of aluminum extrusions because they're all kind of a similar design by default. But I'm just gonna kind of show some more of the details of the design. So this right here, I'm actually just using as an extra piece of extrusion because right now I'm working on the fabric. And so having these little spots here accessible is really handy because I'll show you how I'm attaching all of the fabric. So the fabric, instead of using what a lot of rooftop tents use, is called keter rail. So keter rail is this aluminum channel where you slide a rope in with fabric and it holds it really nicely. You kind of bolt the keter rail onto the side here. So I was looking at that with inflation, things are getting pretty expensive. So I kind of decided to design my own keter rail system. So we have T-channel all around this entire tent. So I tried to basically take advantage of that. So what I did is, with the help of one of my buddies, he's really good at sewing and he was willing to help me with this project, we made these little tab inserts. So you can buy this like acrylic or plastic cord. There's a little sample right there. You can buy that and then you can slide it right into this and then it slides nicely inside of the T-channel, just like this. So the thought process is on the insides of the T-channel, we'll put the fabric, and then on the parts that are going to touch, that'll be rubber stripping so that it can stay waterproof. The bottom of the tent is reinforced with these 1 inch extrusions. So I have basically adapter T-nuts so that I can use smaller 1 inch extrusion bolts on the larger T-channels. Other than that, that's a lot of what of the work that I've gotten done on this thing. The sides have handles all around, like a lot of roof racks have built-in handles, so I wanted to add some handles to this tent. And then I'm using 150 pound gas struts because I'm hoping to put three pretty beefy crossbars on top of the tent, and I just wanted to be able to lift a lot of weight. What else? So the plan is to put one door in the back and then big windows on the sides. If any of you have ever done DIY sewing projects, all the doors on rooftop tent fabric are actually pretty challenging to sew, and they take a lot of time. And this has been a project that's just been kind of going on for too long. I really don't see the benefit of having like a bajillion doors. I just want to have that good airflow. And so I'm just going to put really big windows on the sides and not put doors, just put one door in the back. If you think that's a really bad mistake, comment down below. I'd be interested to hear your thoughts. So this is just a big pack of no-see-um mesh, since you want to be able to keep the mosquitoes out while you're camping. I've also got some plastic down here. So we're going to put some clear plastic on the inside on a zipper so that it's kind of similar to vagabond campers, if you've ever heard of those. They've got plastic on the inside of their doors so that you can open up your windows and, you know, still keep rain out and sit in your tent while it's raining. It's not just only screens where it's not really super waterproof. So here's one of our first pieces that we have done. This is essentially just a little gap jumper between the hinge gap right here. So part of this will slide in the lower area and then it's notched right there so that it can fit around these 90 degree angle points. So that's kind of the design for that. And have just a bunch of zippers down there in a bag. It just takes a lot of time. There's a lot of sewing and a lot of assembly that's involved, and you have to continually assemble and disassemble so that you can test fit things. So that's one benefit of the Keter rail. If you spend a little bit more money, you can have kind of a quick release system for your fabric, which is pretty handy. Again, on this side, these are the longer inserts. So these are just, they slide right in and slide out. And honestly, I think it's gonna work super well. The plan is to basically have these connect to the main piece of fabric, and then water will shed down the side, and then we'll have a rain flap over the side of the tent here. In the scenario where it would get past the tent, rain fly, it would just drain down here into the T-channel and then hopefully out of the tent. It at least would be shed away from most of the fabric and mattress. So still working on where to silicone and waterproof everything, but trying to do our best to keep it all sealed as best we can. So how we are connecting a lot of the main frame is I'm using these black, kind of more decorative 90 degree angle brackets for the corners. And then I'm reinforcing the insides with 90 degree brackets as well. You can see that right there. So that's how I'm setting up all of the corners. And then we've got four big hinges on the front here. And then right on the front will be my huge SS5 light bar that you maybe have noticed hasn't been in a couple of my videos. It's because I'm starting to test fit it on here. Those brackets that I designed were designed for this tent all along. So didn't initially mention that, but that's what they're for. They're designed to fit on this aluminum extrusion channel. So that's, it's pretty sweet. So that's the bulk of the structure of the tent. I'm probably going to be designing some plans for this. So if people are trying to build something similar, I'll have, you know, a detailed document of how I built mine. I'm never gonna vouch for my designs to be like a legal document or something that you can follow step by step for a perfect setup. But I will kind of release documents on my website that just really go into detail about what I've done to build it. And then you can use that as inspiration. You can follow it to a T. There's just always the asterisk that it's not a perfect design, but it's the design that I went with. So that'll be coming out when I, you know, post the final video on this. And then just to kind of show, here's my huge piece of fabric. Just got it laying right here. It's pretty much ready to go on a couple sides, but I haven't fully put it back in. So the part of it that you will see is this side here. And then on this side, we've just got a lot of stitching. This is all gonna be hid by the rain fly. So it's turning out really awesome. So the color scheme is kind of a black tent with this gray fabric. I'm really liking everything about this. I think the aesthetic is gonna be super cool. And the color scheme I'm really excited about as well. So yeah, this is the tent. If you have any questions, feel free to comment down below. I'll be doing probably one more build video showcasing all the fabric, and then I'll do kind of a final reveal. So this video series will maybe be two parts, maybe three parts, but wanted to show some of the, you know, process in the middle of setting this all up. So as far as designing these just a little more, if any of you out there actually sew, the big thing with sewing fabric is you never can have a raw cut edge. You always have to fold it in some way to prevent fraying. So it's nice because you start doubling up fabric and it gets pretty strong, but it also adds a whole nother design element to your dimensions. So this big piece of cardboard is actually a huge stencil I made for one side of the tent, and that allowed me to draw on the huge spool of fabric, because the tent dimensions are, including the extrusions, 53 inches wide and roughly 88 inches long. And so when you have a piece of fabric that large, it starts to get really hard to manage without, you know, drawing everything perfectly on it. You can't just eyeball stuff if you want the fabric to fit tight on the tent. So built a stencil that I could, you know, take and then lay on the fabric, because the fabric pieces, well, what would that be? You know, roughly 7 feet plus 7 feet plus 4 feet or 5 feet. So, you know, it's getting close to 15, 20 feet of fabric. And that's why it's in a massive wad on the floor right here, because it is just a lot to manage. So it's coming together. I'm really excited to show the next stage of the build, but I just wanted to get a little bit of video content out there showcasing the tent. Feel free to comment below if you've got any sort of suggestions or comments on this. Let's quick jump outside. I'm gonna show you how it's gonna end up mounting to the vehicle, and then keep you posted on next steps. So let's jump out to the vehicle and just quick go check that out. So hopefully this isn't too bright, but this is just to kind of showcase how I'm mounting this. So this may look familiar for some of you, but these are actually the tent brackets for the GoFast camper. So these have little spacers that fit under these big rails, and then there's rails on both sides. And these massive holes right here are for 90 degree brackets to bolt to the tent. So the tent should hopefully drop right on top of here, and then I'm gonna build some custom steel brackets to bolt the tent up here. So it should be pretty slick and super customizable. And the goal is, with the 4Runner being so tall already, I can barely fit in a 7-foot garage, by having the tent completely removable, I should be able to still, you know, navigate around parking garages and whatnot while just having the tent pulled off the vehicle. And then once I want my tent, my lights, and any other accessories I bolt to it, that can quickly be dropped right onto the vehicle for a trip or running around town, whatever. So that's kind of the design process here. I think it's gonna work out quite well. All right, well, that's my tent design. If you've got any questions for me in the meantime, feel free to comment below. Thank you so much for supporting me and the channel. Like I've also said, we've got a lot of awesome content coming. Just been super busy in the month of July. Hopefully August is a little more chill. I estimate it will be. So thanks for watching. I'll catch you all in the next video.